When I start thinking about saddling my horse, the most important thing to me is going to be the pad. Honestly, we can talk about saddle fit all day long, but the pad has three really important jobs. The first job for the pad to do is to absorb pressure. The second job is to reduce friction. And the third job is to cool the horse's back. That's simple. Any pad, anywhere, that's its functions. That's what it needs to do. Obviously, some do them much better than others. This is the contoured EVA Sport pad from Weaver. The EVA Sport foam pad has three different layers. We've got the woven top. Underneath, we have the felt liner. And then inside, the EVA Sport foam. So each one does a different job. What you've got down here with the felt is a way to wick moisture away from the horse's back, a natural fiber that pulls the moisture away from the horse's back. There's two ways to cool your horse's back. One is through circulation. So take like a neoprene-based material, and it circulates the sweat and helps the horse's back cool like a radiator would. The other way is through evaporation. That's how ice cream is made. We don't freeze ice cream with ice. We actually create it with evaporation. And so what happens as the horse's back sweats, the felt pulls the moisture away from his back and causes evaporation and cools his back throughout that period. The EVA Sport foam inside, that's very, very similar to the material used inside like football helmets or sport helmets. That's going to absorb a lot of shock. That's going to protect my horse's back. Now, really, you and I don't shock our horse's back that often. But when we're roping and whatnot, there's a lot of jerk and a lot of pull. And so we want to be as careful as we can. Honestly, my ride will be no better than his back is protected. And of course, then I've got this very durable Navajo tight weave top on the pad that's going to protect it, look attractive, and keep it clean and make cleaning it a much easier job. The contour is probably, in my opinion, almost the most important part of this pad. It's built, as you can see, to fit my horse's back. It's measured to accurately ride up over his withers so it's not pulling down tight and causing a fistula on his withers. It's not tearing at the mane hair underneath. Instead, it sets up underneath the gullet of the saddle where it belongs, and then it rides back down here and does its job. By being contoured like this, it gives me a great air tunnel. The more airflow I get through my horse's back, the more evaporation I'm going to create. People frequently say to me, gosh, I'm really worried my pad's creating dry spots. A good pad should. A really good pad should create dry spots because we should be evaporating all the moisture out of there. What you don't want is broken hair, raised welts. You know, if you see a spot on your horse's back where it looks like somebody did kind of one of those old monkey rubs on your head when you were a kid, if you get that broken hair look on his back, that's a problem. But dry spots are actually evaporation and the pad doing its job.